This is Twit.
Gabe, I'm seeing on the lower third is the in charge of the Windows 10 Insiders program, which is awesome. That's the program that we are getting our Windows 10 technical preview on our phones and our computers from. So that's remarkable, that program.
We're really excited about it. It's been fantastic for us. It's just been, you know, a huge pleasure for us to be able to engage with, you know, all the customers who are really excited about using Windows 10. And getting the feedback back that helps us shape the product, it's really been tremendous.
Do you know how many people are actually using the technical previews right now?
Well, there's over 3 million Windows Insiders that are registered. We have, you know, easily 500,000 systems that we see on a daily basis. You know, like people are really using these as their day-to-day machines. I tweeted a month or so ago a chart about the usage of Windows 10 by Windows Insiders, and that trend continues. We see people that are actually using it more heavily than even people using Windows 7, Windows 8. So this is really a super engaged community, and the help that they've provided in terms of sending us problem reports, sending us suggestions, sending us crash reports when something goes wrong on the system. It's really helping us make just a much better product, and we're just couldn't be more pleased with how the program is going.
It's a phenomenal number, I have to say. It's amazing.
All right, it's time to start grilling this guy.
A couple more questions. You have telemetry in the technical preview, so people, even if they're not feeding you feedback reports, you're getting information about how people use it and so forth.
Yeah, we get data on problems that are encountered. We have a whole set of quality telemetry that spans, you know, the big obvious things like crashes and hangs, you know, blue screens. But it also includes things like compatibility errors. It includes responsiveness problems. We have telemetry that tracks app launches, experiences in the shell to see how long things are taking, and then we can pivot that across device classes and understand, you know, how something works on a high-end system or on an entry-level system, and then we, you know, on our side we can tune for that. We can change memory management, prefetching logic to optimize for sort of the most common cases. We actually optimize the product using basic block optimization for just how, like, parts of binaries get loaded, what load order happens. And so all of that responsiveness telemetry, for example, helps us do that.
And that's great.
Being able to get that from people that are really using it as their day-to-day product will just, again, help us deliver a better final result.
But I have to say to the guy in the chat room who said, can I give you feedback without actually installing it? That's probably less valuable.
That's the type of feedback he's looking for.
We do actually, we have a user voice. We have, you know, the ability to give us suggestions on things that you'd like to see in the product in the future.
Okay, good.
You know, the most actionable things for us, though, are things that are people like really using every day. And, you know, and I was listening, you know, Paul talk about things like the annoyances of function keys and things like that. Those things where there's friction in your day-to-day experience, or there's things that you want us to do that will help the day-to-day usage of the product and really optimize your experience. Those are the and that comes from really using the product. You know, one of my teams is focused entirely on performance. And one of the things that I always talk about with that team is that, you know, with 1.5 billion customers, if we can save 1 second of time on an operation, the amount of time, you know, put back into the world, the productivity put back into the world is profound. It's like 32 years of productivity on that single second of improvement. And so we look for, you know, every single opportunity that we can get to shave time to optimize in that way. And, you know, we'll sit in conference rooms and argue about, you know, 150 milliseconds on some operation. How can we get that 150 milliseconds back? So, you know, there's some people that are hyper focused on this stuff here, and it's great to work with them.
Yeah, it's more than a tenth of a second. You know, I mean, that counts, man. That's
you know, it does add it up across number of systems, number of operations that you do per day. Those little things they matter.
Okay, now I'll let you guys talk.
All right. Okay. let's just get the elephant in the room out of the way.
Are you calling
me fat? Everybody wants to know.
No, I'm the elephant. I'm leaving now. Goodbye.
Not going to ask you about Hadoop. But where is the next Windows 10 mobile preview? Soon? Maybe today? Any hints for us about this thing?
Sure. How about this as a hint? Yes, I'll give you a straight answer. I will actually do something that I've said that I wouldn't do, which is give you a date for when the next build is happening. And then I'll tell you a story about why we're doing it this way. We will have a new build. It will be available 10 a.m. on Friday.
Wow.
And the reason that I can give you that, you know, concrete prediction is that because this new build actually has a significant number of new phones that we're unlocking for the first time, we actually have to do a ton of staging work to get the build staged and ready. The set of phones that we are making this work on for this build, it actually translates to about 5,100 images. That have to be staged for every mobile operator for language, and so that takes time. Even at a minute per build for staging, we have to start that long in advance. So we pushed the button basically yesterday, and it will be, or actually it was late last night, and the staging began. And so Friday at 10 a.m. staging will be complete, and all those phones that were listed will be available, with one exception. The icon is not going to make it for this build for the same reason that the...
Oh, Mary Jo.
Mary Jo just walks away.
What about the 9:30? Okay.
The 9:30 also. The core issue there is that... The issue is that the 9:30 and the icon, they actually require us to add a new scale factor for those screen sizes. And you know, we looked at a couple different ways that we could sort of work around it, but it wound up in cases where the UI would be just too small to use on that phone. So we do have workbook to add that scale factor for those devices, but for this next build, they won't be supported. The rest of the phones on the list will be.